Hello, welcome to the channel, and today I will be sharing on this skill payout issue that everybody is very concerned. Like, everybody is trying to maximize their earning, and then they are very confused. Like, a lot of people are sharing their spreadsheet on like whether is it like a combination of 80 stamina, 160 stamina, or 40 stamina is better, or 200 stamina is better. So today I'm going to share with you all how is it actually calculated. So we have from the white paper, okay, the skill payout is actually given by the gas offset plus the baseline multiplied by enemy power over 1000, and then the enemy power is actually based on the power. If you are stronger, then the enemy will be stronger as well, plus minus 10% of your power. So how do we get all this value in the game? So we go to our game. Okay, all my characters are full stamina, so I need to start fighting. So let me just show you all how to get the value. So you go to the earning calculator. So you can see from the earning calculator, mouse over this question mark, you get a 0.003695 gas offset, and then 0.00153. We call this the baseline. Okay, this is what we call the baseline here. So these are the two values in terms of skill, and then I convert them to the actual USD, like now it's 39.50. So everything will change. So what is going to happen here is what you need to fill in is all this blue color. Okay, all the blue color you need to fill in, and then by filling in the power, you get a combat multiplier. What do I mean by combat multiplier? This square root enemy power over 1000. So that's our baseline. So our baseline, which is this thing DB here, we will multiply by this amount. So the stronger we are, the stronger, like say for example your level 11, you meet an enemy that's around 4000 power, then your multiplier is 2, then you will get the earning you will get using 40 stamina is based on this formula here. I call this equation ABCD of values ABCD. So it's like A, the gas rebate that you get, plus the multiple of baseline multiplied by E, B times E. Okay, here, this is the game default value. Okay, it changes over time. Then this is how strong you are, the variable. Everybody will have the same A and B, but the E, the combat multiplier, varies. If your character is very strong, as you are level 41, good weapon, you got a 20k attack, then you will get something like a 4 times multiplier on this value. And how much is this? Is 6 cents. So you get like 25 to 30 cents after the multiplier per 40 stamina, then plus the gas rebate. As you can see, actually the gas rebate given is actually lagging behind because the Oracle is lagging behind. We have $40 and the Oracle is at $60, assuming it's $60. So actually we only get back 15 cents for every 25 cents that we spend for gas. And that is the very reason why using 40 stamina and sending a lot of transaction is very not worthy. If you were to send like all 4-5 hits in the 200 stamina hit, then we will save a lot of transaction fee. Okay, so I would advise people to do the fights in 160 stamina or 200 stamina at one go, because if you were to do one by one, you're actually only going to gain like 16 cents every battle. Even you're very strong, if you're like not so strong, you're just an average player, 10,000 attack, you're gonna earn like 9 cents, 8.7 cents. You know, this is the 0.008, like almost not even 10 cents per battle, okay, for 40 stamina. And then if you want to say okay, 200 stamina, you multiply by 5, you earn a 40 cents on level 31 character, you know, every 16 hours, 200 stamina, you earn 40 cents. That's very, very bad. But if you were to do 5 hits, actually you see the value, you're almost earning double. You're earning double for if you were to do 5 hit at one go. Okay, so that is very important. We earn a lot more if we were to send this, because the earnings are very marginal, and then we need to save every cent. Like, see this every 10 cent that we save is our profit. So the earning can be twice as much if you were to send 200 stamina. But however, for me, I usually want to do 160. Why do I not do 200? Because remember, this power is vary on your weapon. If I'm forced to, like say for example, I go to my account now, I get all full stamina, I need to start hitting. See, all are full stamina, and then I need to pick a weapon. This is a water. So imagine I just pick a random water sword. So you see, I am forced, like there is no good match for me. I cannot pick my good enemy. Or in fact, the difference will be even bigger. For example, if I go to a better account, let's say, I go to account with better weapons. Okay, that is very similar. For example, I have 5-star weapon here. Now you see, I can find good match and bad match. So lucky I can find a good match, so that is good. See, this is 18,000, so if you say 18,000 and 586. See, I will get approximately in the dollar. Okay, we will see how much skill do we earn. We earn 36694. 0.036694. Okay, and then how much do we earn from this is actually multiply by the dollar. This is actually almost 150 earning. It's 150. This is what we call a 5-star sword. 5-star sword can give me a $1.50, but I need to minus away the transaction fee. How do we know the transaction fee? Okay, we can get the actual transaction fee by going into here. I go to this and then go to this, the old one. I go to here. You can see I only pay 25 cents. Actually, I only use 0.0007 gas. Okay, and what are 0.0007 BNB, which is only 25 cents. So I minus away 25 cents. My profit is 120 for this one click, which is quite worthy if I have 5-star. But the problem is what? When I go to the second page, oh, I got no good match. I go to here. Okay, here I get some good match. Okay, I will be able to get another victory. But you see, then this character, the second character, doesn't get a good match. But he's at 200 stamina. Then he'll be very wasted because the stamina is not going to gain after 200. So my optimal strategy is to just start hitting at 160. If I don't find a good enemy, I will wait for 1 hour, the enemy will refresh. And then I will wait for the get a better match. And then if I can get a sure victory, then I will earn money. Because it's actually very, I lose a lot if I change a weapon. You see here, it's still another 150. But look at me, if I have no choice in a rush of time, this is quite dangerous already. So I will not, this is a 33 XP, I will not do this. So for, because now, usually I will not do so late, because today is Saturday, and then I'm also trying to prepare for this video. So it takes me quite some preparation time. So here, still no good matchup, so I have to keep changing to a lousier and lousier, so I finally find a good match. But look at this enemy, it's only because of the lousy sword, my power multiplied by this is a very low multiplier. I only fight a very weak enemy, so the payout will be a lot lesser. Okay, I will get like very little. If I will go 8390, I would expect my earning to be just 77 cents compared to this $1 after cost. So we said we get the 2-star, but this is a very good 2-star, almost max 2-star attack. So here we get 0.025867, and then this is equal to this multiplied by the skill cost, and then here we just drag down actually. Yeah, you see we get 77 cents, which is exactly how we predicted it would be. Okay, based on this, the actual, here is the game actual value, and then this is my calculator, my calculated values. Okay, so here, a 5-star and a 3-star is almost 50 cents difference, or if you want the percentage difference, it will be this, it will be like this minus this, we need to bracket. Actually, it's a very big, you might see like 50 or 40 cents, but then it's actually a very big difference. You see, it's a 55% gain. If I were to use 2-star versus this in terms of percentage, I gain 50% more. 50% more earning if I were to use the 5-star. So actually, if I can use a stronger weapon, I will always want to use the stronger weapon. And this extra weapon will outweigh this extra the 10 cents that I waste for sending the battle. Because I mean, ultimately, you will be sending like 160 or 200. So it's very close, like you spread over the cost. So you actually save, you only waste a little bit more if you were to send 160 stamina. But then you see, if I get to use my best weapon, I earn a lot more. I will cover more on the weapon optimization later, and then also the earning table of the weapons. So now we continue with the basics, okay? So here, see, if I have no choice, see, I can't choose my enemy, and my enemy has to choose me. I can't use my I can't use my 5-star sword. Actually, I can wait lah, but then I don't want lah. I mean, yeah, just go for this. Yeah, don't waste away. Ultimately, we want to. This is not a guaranteed victory. You can use the simulator to decide lah. But then I want to just quickly clear all because I have a lot of max out stamina. Character is all wasting lah. So I don't want to waste time. So this is very good earning, about 120 per hit. So we can get around 3 times of this every 2 days. So you can go and do the math yourself. 16 hours every 3 days. Every 2 days, I can do 3 200 stamina. So I can get back around $4. $4 every 2 days. Yeah. So you can go and do the math yourself. Then and also about this thing, when we send the transaction, okay, let me just go back to another account. Not this one has that weapon. Let me just go to this one. Okay, then we will go and choose a weapon, earth weapon. Okay, so okay, here earth weapon, I will fight a lot. This lightning is too strong for me. I will go for something easy. Okay, either this or this water. Okay, this water looks easy. So we fight this guy and then yeah, this is a 29 experience lah. Then it should be a guaranteed victory. I wanted to show something with the gas fee. Okay, let's just talk a bit more about the gas fee. And I mean, people who are new to the blockchain are not really familiar with, but I can just share a little bit on this lah. Let's wait for the result so I can pick another attack. Okay, so go to the next enemy. So we try to use our this sword as much as possible. Here, this is a 31. Very good. So you see, when we click the transaction, you see, wow, you see, oh, this is going to cost us 0.0025 BNB. Yeah, because like this is the gas price and that's the gas limit. Okay, gas limit is the maximum amount that we want to pay. Actually, we can increase this. It doesn't affect the gas price. I can show you all later lah. So here, we're going to just send this, but we are not. Do remember, we are not going to spend this amount. Okay, a lot of people have this misconception that we are spending this much BNB, but no, we are not spending this amount. This is going to, this is like a lot more like this 25, this is like 80 cents. You are like, oh wow, we are spending 80 cents to send a battle, but this is not the amount that we are paying. You're not paying so much. You can press confirm and then we can go and check the actual transaction when it is done. We don't spend that one. The 100% limit is that is the limit that we are going, but we only usually see that is the 500,000 limit that we promise, like the maximum we are willing to go, but actually we don't use that much. And then how they charge us is how much we use. Okay, this is our maximum quote. We didn't use, we only use 140k. We use 28%, so actually we only pay 28%, which is 25 cents USD. So that is the actual amount that we are paying. We are not paying the full amount. That is the limit. Okay, we can show you like, actually I can just send one with a more limit. Let me find no good match. This is also not a good match, but there's no, so I have to change sword. But usually if my stamina is not full, that's why I said I will do at 160, so I can keep filtering better enemies. So now I got no choice, but I have to do this lah, because I got a lot to clear now. So I fight this. So actually here you see I can go to 6 or even 7. Go to 7. 70k gas limit. And I would expect the cost to be still around 25 cents. You see, I can increase. You can increase or decrease, it don't really affect. But try not to change the gas limit too much lah, because yeah, it's still, I mean, if you don't know how it works, it's better not to. Yeah, we can go achieve the condition is here. So you see, we send with a gas limit of 7. You see here we send 700,000, but how much do you pay? You see, we use 141, they will still charge us based on 141. See, I still pay 25 cents. So you can go to 1 million, 10 million gas limit you want, but then better not do it. Because if the network is congested and then your transaction stays in the chain for too long, you might actually pay your maximum 100%. And then so better not touch this thing, okay? So this is the maximum amount that you're willing to risk. If the network is very congested, it will take more gas. But if, I mean, for now it's very smooth, so we only use 20% or like say 28% every time. So we don't need to pay you see, like, see, we use 5, they only use 141 K gas, we only pay 25 cents. It doesn't matter. Okay, it doesn't matter. Like we set to a higher limit. You see here, we set to a 700,000 limit. But we still charge the same. So this gas limit, a lot, I see a lot of YouTubers are actually give false info, not false information, maybe it's also they don't know. They try to ask people to lower this gas limit, you know, like it's actually a very dangerous thing to do if you were to try and lower your gas limit. Let me explain why. Like if I were to try and fight and then okay, I say okay, this is a good enemy. I try to lower the gas limit, it's very dangerous if I were to do like say like that. You see, if I go too low, what happens is that my transaction will be cancelled and then I still need to pay. And then nothing will happen. So I try not to lower it too much. Okay, but we know, I mean, through this previous few battle, we know we usually use around 140k, even if you like oh go 150, this will definitely make it. We will be able to go this enough, but we don't need to change, we can just put 500k because we are still going to pay the same 25 cents. But the problem, the risk is if you were to put like just 150 here, the problem is what? Your transaction might fail. Your transaction might fail and you are wasting all these 25 cents for nothing. So never go and lower this. Just set it to default is actually very good for us already. Yeah, there's no need to go and touch this value like, if you don't know how the blockchain works. And then there's this gas is that you can pay more per unit and then people will do your transaction faster. So this one you also try not to touch because I don't think the network is going to be congested so much nowadays. Yeah, but you if you change the gas fee, the gas price, then you charge more. That means like based on how many gas you use multiply by this gas price, then it will charge you this value. This 140 multiply by this per BNB per gas use, you will get this cost. So that's how they charge you for the transaction fee. Okay, so we need to quickly clear and then yeah, I think. Okay, I need to go back to my account. Actually, I shouldn't be. Okay, let me just go to one last example. Let's continue with our this sharing. Actually, maybe I will just finish my stamina and share the earning table and how to optimize weapon in the next video. I'm going to clear my stamina first. Yeah, thank you for watching and I hope you learn something new.